Hi, this is Richard from Rich Media Design Productions. Today we're going to work on making an avatar from a photograph. We've pre-chosen here a photograph of Megan Fox, who happens to be a pretty good subject. And we'll go up here to the layer section. As you can see, it's the background layer now. We'll go to the top right-hand corner and go and say duplicate layer. This will create a new layer that we can work with. We don't want to destroy or augment the original. That way we can keep the original and have the avatar from the duplicate. Okay, next step is filter and brush strokes, accent edges. And you'll see that we'll have Megan Fox here kind of freckled to an extreme here. I think she's already freckled, but we don't want to augment that part of her. So here at the right-hand top corner here, we have edge width, and we want to set that to 2. That means that the edges are going to be all the way down to the very minimum, or a smaller minimum. And then the edge brightness, we want to bring it all the way up to the top to 46. And the smoothness all the way up to 15. I think the last step is 16, and it actually is the very, very top, 15. Okay. So we'll accept that by saying OK, and you'll see that the duplicate is now quite affected by this filter that we just applied. Next step is to go back to filters and go to distort and diffuse glow. Now you'll see that there's a reddish color to this diffusement, but don't get worried if it's a different color for you, because it picks up your background color. And if you have a red background color, it's going to affect the picture with that color. So, if you're anticipating a particular color that you want, change your background color before you do this part, and you'll be okay. But I'll show you another trick on how to change it. Now, the reason I have red in there is because I want to make certain things a little redder, and that way I could affect the picture a little bit better. So anyway, on the top right-hand corner again, we'll have graininess, and we want that down to 0. We're going to take all that grain. Now, if I take it up a little bit further, you're going to see that there's some grain to this photograph, and we don't want that. We want it very smooth, so we'll take it all the way down to 0, and you can see that the effect is actually taking place. The glow will be 2. Now that's already set, so that's fine. And the clear amount will be 20, which is all the way to the right. That seems to be acceptable, and that's your finished avatar, actually. Now, if I took the magnifying and demagnify it and brought it down to an avatar size, I could see what this image is going to look like. Now, here's some things that you might want to do to this photograph, and that is change this color background. Now, you can go to your replacement color tool, which is right on your left hand side, the spider brush tool, one of the pull down menus, and this will actually replace colors that you have on your image. Okay, now I want to change this red. I'm going to go up here and change the size of this brush to let's say, oh, that sounds, that could be bigger. Yeah, there. And we'll change the color here to blue. sort of mix it all up together. Now, I'm going to go over here to my layer colors. You know, I have a background layer and a foreground layer. I'm going to change it to red and pick my replacement tool again. It's already been placed. Change my size to about a little bit smaller than that, because I want to go and kind of touch up her lips. And we can go in here and now kind of redden her lips. Now, this is, you know, optional. You don't have to do what I'm doing. I'm just showing you how this replacement color tool works and how you can actually make it work, either changing certain colors or not. Now, I should have probably left her darkened part of her lip, that line that goes and separates the two. So what I'll do is I'll go in there and I'll erase that. No, I'll just leave it. Okay, so there you are. I'm going to reduce it down to show you what an avatar looks like. And there you have it. Good for any website, and use it as you wish. There's your avatar. Thank you for joining. If you have any suggestions about what you'd like to see, just drop me a little note, and I'll take a look at it and see if we can do it the next time. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again soon. Bye.